Hi. Last month, my hubby gave me an ultimatum. Shut down by 7 p.m. I was really angry at first. I'm a grown woman. How can anyone impose anything on me like this? It sounded like a curfew. But when I calmed down, I understood the reasons behind it. You see, as businesswoman, it's very difficult for me to disconnect from work. So even when I'm not at my desk, I'm constantly thinking, planning, strategizing in my head about my work. There was never truly a disconnection. So I empathized with my hubby and gave him my word. With the pandemic making millions of us work from home, the right to disconnect has never been more important. And I know exactly how difficult it is to disconnect from work. So that's what I wanted to talk to you about today. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you a system or hacks that can help you truly disconnect from work. Let's get started. If this is your first time here, welcome to my channel. My name is Aparna. I am a certified coach. Every week, I bring to you tips, tricks, tools, and hacks that can help you upskill your life. And if this interests you, do consider subscribing to my channel on YouTube. And while you're there, do not forget to press the bell icon so you're notified every week when I post a new video. And if you're watching this on Facebook, do remember to follow and like my page. We're already reeling under pandemic-related anxiety, and we don't want burnout due to overworking. While flexibility to work from home is important, having the courage to truly disconnect from work is equally important. We need to create our personal boundaries or hard stops so that we can create a balance between work life and non-work life. The struggle is real, and I totally understand that, but it's not impossible. So when my hubby demanded that I disconnect, I simply was not able to. But I had given him my word, and there's ego to handle. So in order for me to succeed in it, this is what I've done. The first hack is to disconnect physically. When we are working in flow, it's easy to spill over your self-set boundaries. That is why physical disconnection initially is very, very important. So to disconnect physically, I took digital help. I set downtime limits in my screen time app. This shuts down all my productivity and creativity apps that I use for work by 7 p.m. Although it will allow me to use it as long as I keep keying in the password every single time. So you see, this actually helps me or gave me a reminder to shut down. The second hack is to schedule a non-work activity immediately post the curfew time. I always wanted to have my dinner early because I have seen that the day I have my dinner early, the next day I am extremely energetic, and not just that, I also tend to lose few kilos. I couldn't do it earlier because of my work. So now that I have time and I'm disconnecting at 7, I immediately schedule my dinner post the curfew time. And physical disconnection is a reminder for me to do just that. So when my system shuts down, I immediately get up, fix and have my dinner between 7:30 and 8. Believe me, the thrill of losing weight is a motivation enough for me to continue doing this diligently. The third hack is to start everything early. Because I have my dinner early, I'm able to retire to bed by 10 p.m. And because I sleep early, I'm able to wake up by 5:30 a.m. And because I woke up early and energetic, I do not miss my workout routine and meditation. And I also start working early because I know I have to cut off at 7 p.m. This is a positive loop. And because I see the benefits, I am motivated enough to keep doing it again and again. So there you are. Those are the three hacks that I put into place so that I can truly disconnect from work. These three hacks: disconnect physically, immediately schedule a non-work activity, and to start everything early, have been giving me tremendous results, and therefore I'm disciplined enough to follow them. Remember, self-discipline begins with the mastery of your thoughts. If you don't control what you think, you cannot control what you do. So I urge you to think that you can disconnect from your work. Think that you can get back to doing all those things that you want to do now that you are at home. And I also urge you to try these three hacks and see if they can work for you as well. Don't forget to tell me about it though. Leave me a note in the comment section below, or you may reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. Thank you so very much for watching. If you like this video and you find it resourceful, you know what to do. Hit that like button and share it with your friends. And I'll see you next week. Until then, stay home, stay safe. Take good care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye.